Welcome and be inspired with Dominic. And this is a cute tool, isn't it? Well, no, actually it isn't. But now it is. Googly eyes just make anything better. Even woodworkers. Let me show you how to make them.
To make your tools, or anything else for that matter, goggly, you can of course buy goggly eyes. Not that impressive, right? I know you can buy bigger ones, but where would be the fun in that? Also, you can customize the homemade ones to your liking. The quickest way I found uses coin boxes or cases, the kind that coin collectors use. To make things simpler yet, let me give you my 2 cents. Literally. For speed's sake, I spray paint one side of the cover white and one coin black. Let it dry, put it together, and you are done. Keep in mind that while these coins work well, they are also heavier than plastic or plywood circles and thus will be less goggly. For the next version, you need plastic watch covers. You can get them from broken watches or buy them. Glass works, I guess, but it has some drawbacks as well, like weight and breaking in unpleasant ways. As backer, I take a piece of white plastic, trace a circle and cut it out on the scroll saw. While I'm here, I also cut smaller circles for the actual pupil. On a side note, whenever you need to cut something on a saw where it might fall in and out of reach, use a piece of plywood or OSB as makeshift zero clearance insert. Make sure to hold it in place using clamps, and nothing will be able to flee from you into the depth of your saw ever again. You want to prevent the pupil from getting stuck, and these watch covers are concave. To make sure that will not be an issue, you should file the pupils down to somewhat of a concave shape as well. Apart from not gluing yourself to the eyes, you need to take care not to get the pupil glued to anything else. It still works as an eye if that happens, but it will not goggle as effectively. Need something bigger? Coming right up. For this we need blanks, and the most basic version can be made on the lathe. I will show you another way in a moment. I put a piece of scrap wood on a faceplate and turn it with a gentle radius. The idea here is, drumroll, vacuum forming. And full disclosure, I'm not going to finish those, at least not these ones exactly, because I made a mistake when making the vacuum forming mold. But before we get to that, let's make another shape on the belt sander. This one will be elongated and not symmetrical. Now we need a vacuum table, which is a sturdy box with holes. Place the blank on the side with many holes and make sure it stays there. Take the piece of plastic, place it on top and heat it up with a hot air gun. If you want to use this technique more often, you can put the plastic in a wooden frame and heat it up in the oven and then place it on here. Once the plastic is flexible, turn on the shopvac, connect it to the hole at the bottom of the box and… yeah. Give it time to cool and harden, then you can cut it apart and remove the overhang. I made a mistake when making the vacuum forming mold. What I should have done is make it a little taller, so that the plastic would form at least a little bit of a vertical wall before it goes into this radius that you tend to get, or that I tend to get, and I might not have used the best plastic. Also, I overheated it in one spot and it became milky, so it's still a good technique to make googly eyes, but do it right and not the way I did. But wait, there's more. Maybe you want something more banana. This is arguably easier than the vacuum formed version. You need 2 plywood rings, a plywood circle and a plastic circle with the same outer diameter. Stack them like this. Circle, ring, plastic, circle. Recognize it? To finish the minion eyes, I start the paint job before I glue those pieces together, because there is probably no good way to actually paint the inside of the rings while they're attached to the plastic. At least without marring the plastic. I use the A-glue to make a plastic sandwich from the 2 rings, and then small screws to attach the back, just in case there is some issue with sawdust getting in or moisture or whatever. This black plastic has a tendency of attracting sawdust, so I use compressed air to clean it thoroughly before I lock it in. Due to the nature of minions, you can get away with a single eye.
Well, it still looks better than the original, doesn't it? Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please share it and subscribe to my channel. And, as always, remember to be an eye. No, remember to be inspired. I wish that had been scripted.